Good morning, everybody. Grandpa Cotton. How y'all doing today? I'm doing fair to middling. Old stomach still giving me problems. Today we're going to be working on this fabulous, this wonderful Minn Kota Edge trolling boat. That's right. We're working on it again. And you know, I ain't never had a trolling motor this sorry, I'm gonna tell you. I know there's a lot of them out there, but I have never had a trolling motor this sorry. This trolling motor ain't even a year old. It'll be a year old in August. I called a manufacturer yesterday about more parts on it. Look, I'm gonna tell y'all something, that limited warranty, if it ain't got something to do with that electric motor right there, you can forget it. It ain't no good for nothing. But anyhow, I'm gonna quit bashing the motor. It ain't gonna do no good. I mean, I know there's a lot of y'all on these motors probably ain't never had no problem with. This motor stays in the garage in my boat. I mean, it's hooked to the boat. And it picks a switch in this thing. If I wanna pack this thing up, take it off the boat, unbolt it, put it in a box, and ship it to them. And they'll pay for this little switch in the return shipping. Which, I don't even know what I've done with a switch. Is that it? That's for a switch right here. We got it for about $15 from a company down there in Louisiana. He's in West Monroe. I don't even know what the name of the marine place is. But anyhow, this little old switch right here, if I'd have sent this trolling motor back to the manufacturer there somewhere up north, that little switch right there would wind up costing me a couple $100s. So we're gonna do it ourselves today. Let me go get a few tools together and we'll take this puppy apart. Look, it's already done fell apart. Knob done fell off front. Switch don't work. I got this little piece here. It would underneath the bottom of it. That's another piece of it. Well, it amounted to the switch quit working on it. We went fishing in it. I wound up having number one on the speed, and that thing's worthless on this trolling motor. So let me get a wrench, and we'll take this thing off, and we'll take it apart and take a look at it. Hold on just a minute. We gotta first get this old foot out of here. I'm gonna tell y'all something. I'm the type of person that when I buy something, if it's a good product, I'm gonna tell everybody in America how wonderful your product is and how great it is. And I'm gonna brag on it. But when I buy a product, spend $600-$700 on something, and have to work on it continuously, I'm gonna tell everybody how sorry your product is. That's just me. That's the way Grandpa Cotton rolls. I hope everybody else like that. I done replaced several parts in that trolling motor. I was gonna say I got some over here. I got them stapled up over there while I won't lose. The Carter key pin, the shear pins, we call them shear pins. Shear pins they sell in them props right there are aluminum. I suggest the first thing you do when you buy a Minn Kota Edge trolling motor is you take that prop off and you order you some steel shear pins. Because if you don't, the first log you hit with that trolling motor, it's going to shear the pin. I'm going to tell you something. I think they make these things for them lakes up there. They sure don't make them for no bayous and no rivers, I'm going to tell you. That's enough of that. Let's get on with this repair job. Let me get this pedestal out of here. I always put my pedestal down, my foot control down to the boat, because here where I live is, we have these big giant rivers, and it can get real rough on these rivers real quick. I'm gonna tell y'all what, first thing you do if you buy that kind of trolling motor right there, you cut the rope off, the pull-up rope. That thing will stretch all the way to the back of the boat back there if you ain't careful. They little old switches, they easy to fix. I mean, they don't require a whole lot to fix them. It's just aggravating having to fix them on a new trolling motor. I had that old motor guide over there. I had that thing for 30 years. Maybe I'm just spoiled. Maybe stuff's supposed to last. Ain't supposed to last that long, I don't know. I guess I'm gonna take this thing and plug it apart. Popo's got it. All the wires buckled down. Alright, here we go. Let's see here. Well, we got another one over. We can turn it over right here and work on it. Let me see about getting this camera up here where we're working it. Hold on a minute. Alright, I got y'all here. We can see what we're doing. The switch sits up inside this thing in there, right in there. What we're gonna do, we're gonna take her loose. Well, I think I'm gonna have to do is get a ratchet. There it is, right there. There's the culprit right there. Y'all hang on just a minute. Take this thing loose and put everything back where it goes. This thing's got a plus and an R on the back of it. Like right there. You can see it. I only got 4 plugs, so don't be sure all your plugs go back in the same spot. You're gonna see if we can push the pop of this thing off of this R here. I don't know why they make these little switches like they do. And that's gonna go on the R. That don't even fit right. We can tighten it down a little bit, maybe. We can tighten them little old lugs down by just squeezing them there a little bit. And, good snug on down. Gotta push it up on that kind of hard if you don't tear everything up on it. Alright, we got that one on. We'll take the hot wire off now, the plus wire. I'm gonna tell y'all what I'm seeing on this switch. Y'all know what I'm fixing to say before I see. Yep, that's what I'm fixing to say. It says made in Korea, not China. Alright, the other side over here has got a W and a Y on it. Okay? All you gotta do is just make sure they go on the right one. And hopefully, I don't know what the deal is with a knob. I might have to order a new knob. That there's gonna go on the W. Pull you over here and put you on there. Somehow or another, I reckon. That's a W. I ain't got one more little wire here. I'm gonna do it my screwdriver. We got a Y. These things here are kind of like a dimmer switch on a fan, on a ceiling fan or something. I mean, alright. See if my little knob here going. Something fell off this little old knob. I ain't exactly sure what it was. Where my trolling motor blade is. Let's see. Be sure it's clear. They're not gonna hit nothing. Well, that's supposed to be the right switch. Well, it just turns around and around. Let's turn it on. Let's see. All right, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six. Hey, I got a 6-speed. All right. All right, she's running like she's supposed to run. See, a lot of people take these. To trouble. I'm going to tell you, this thing fell off. This little knob here fell off. I think what it had a little keeper that slid in there and kept around. It's got a little metal piece in there that I guess protects the plastic when it slides up on there. Well, now I had tried to push it back on there before I bought this new switch, and that little metal piece just fell down inside of here. So what I done is I picked it out and pulled it to get this metal piece out, and I flooded this whole thing. I go all the way down to the bottom, it's hollered. I flooded that whole tube with hot glue all the way up to about right here. That little piece was about that long. I pushed that little piece back, and that way it won't push. When you put it back on, it won't push all the way down in there and your knob fall off. So that's just a little tip. So we're going to get this thing's in number 5. So I'm assuming it's going to go like that. That's the way we're going to put it in here. All right, number 5. All right, you just got to unloosen the nut here. It's got some little keepers on it, looks like. So, you want to be sure that it goes back into the proper spot. It's got 2 spots in there, but be sure it goes back in the right one. Be sure it's turned the right direction. And you know, this thing's got a half slot. It don't even have a hole this thing goes. It looks like they'll put a hole there for it to slide in. But I guess that's the way things is made nowadays. I hope y'all enjoyed these old videos. We're going to try to tighten this thing up. It's really kind of weird the way it's made. Probably supposed to take this thing completely apart, but I ain't taking all them gears and pulleys and all that off of there. You don't have to do all that. One more little snug. Like that. Got it. You put the seal and get the knob to go back on it. I'm gonna tell you right now. Looks like she might be fixed. Let's see. Well. Why won't it turn? Now, that don't make no sense, y'all. What's it? Really? Oh, okay, this thing's got a little notch there when it looks like. See if she works now. Push it all together. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, guys. Looks like we got it fixed up. Here's the little switch. See that? I'm gonna prove to you where it's made from. Look at that. Y'all see that? I don't like that. That's made in China here. That's made in Taiwan. Are these supposed to be American made trolling motors from America? Y'all be the judge on it. Y'all be the judge. Alright, that's gonna wrap it up. Hope y'all enjoyed this work video. I know I complain a lot about the Minn Kota trolling motor, but I'm just trying to keep y'all making a mistake buying one of them. But anyhow, until the next time, y'all remember, got a fishing tournament coming up August 1st, dead late with the kids. Y'all bring your kids, we're gonna have a great time. So until the next time, remember, work hard and study. Take a kid fishing, take a kid hunting, that's what we're supposed to do. Thank all y'all for your generous donations, for the ones who y'all who give to the cause to give these kids. And until the next time, Grandpa Cotton is gone.